بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Dua to make a task easy and finish it with a good ending. Rabbi yassir wa la tu'assir wa tammim bil khair.
Assalamualaikum students. Hi, how are you all? I hope you will be fine and safe. Student, as you know, I am Miss Atiya. Student, have you completed your winter vacation work? If you did not complete winter vacation work, so complete this because submission date of winter back is 11 January till 13 January 2021, and marks of winter back are 10 marks that will be included in your midterm results. So today we are starting new chapter, chapter 7, and name is. Financial arithmetic. Okay, the topic chapter name is financial arithmetics. Student, first we will discuss about this method. Okay, what we will learn in this chapter? Student, we will learn in this chapter arithmetic operations by unitary method, and we will calculate profit and loss, and also we will calculate the percentage. Student, first we will discuss about the arithmetics. Think about this arithmetics. What is arithmetic, student? Arithmetic is the root of a Greek word ortho, which means is number. Okay, and student, arithmetics is the base or is the most frequently used part in mathematics. And student, in arithmetic operation is based on the measurement of price and measurement of length, area, volume, and time. Student, we will solve arithmetic operation by unitary method. So we will discuss about that. What is the unitary method? Student, suppose I have these four pointers. Okay, students. Suppose if the cost of one marker is given, suppose it's 10, and I have to calculate the cost of 3 marker. So it is very easy. I will multiply 10 by 3. Okay, definitely. So I can find the cost of price of 3 marker. Suppose if the price of 4 marker given directly. Okay, and I have to find the price of 2 marker. Student, this is the difficult for me. Okay, how can I calculate? So student, this method we will solve in unitary method. We will determine the price of group of object. Student, now come on the exercise. Exercise 7A. I am reading question 1. If a bag containing 12 kg of basmati rice sells as rupees 492, find the cost of 2 kg of rice. In the question, students, the cost of 12 kg rice is given, and we have to find the 2 kg rice. The cost of 2 kg rice we have to find. How can we find? I am writing here first question number. We are solving question number 1. Okay, and now starting from solution. What is solution, student? We are solving these all questions by unitary method. And unitary method, you will give proper description of the question, and in answer you will write in proper description. Okay, so first we will make the data first. Data is this, that the cost of 12 kg rice is 492 rupees. Okay. The cost of 12 kg rice is given already. Okay. and what we have to find? Cost of 2 kg rice. We have to find this. Okay? We have to find this. Cost of 2 kg rice. Now, what we will do, student? First, cost of 12 kg rice is given. 492 rupees. Student, first we will find the cost of 1 kg rice. When we will find the 1 kg rice cost, so we can easily find the 2 kg rice cost. Okay, now I am finding first. Cost of 1 kg rice. First, I am finding this. Remember this? We are going toward the greater value to smaller value. Okay? So, we will divide. We will divide. Cost is 492. So, I will divide. Okay? I will divide this 12. 2492. Okay? Now, we can divide easily. We will divide this in calculation word. Now, can make here a calculation column. Okay. Now, I made here. I am placing 9492 inside and 12 outside. Now, I will read the table. Do you know 4 times 12 is 48? Reminder is 1. Now copy this 2 here. 1 times 12 is 12. Completely divided. Okay? Okay, now answer is 48. So, cost of 1 kg rice is 41 rupees. Now let's, we will find the 2 kg rice, cost of 2 kg rice. This is the demand of question. Very easy. So cost of 2 kg rice will be, student, now listen carefully. Now we are going toward the smallest value to the bigger value. This time we will multiply. Okay, if we are going smallest value to bigger or greater value, so we will multiply, or greater value to smaller, so we will divide. What would be the answer? Now do this multiplication work in calculation column. 1 times 2 is 2 and 4 times 2 is 8. Okay, now give the answer in proper description. So, cost of 2 kg rice is 82 rupees. This is the answer. This is the answer of question A. Question now, question 3 I am reading. Okay? Question 3 is, a factory worker can produce 28 toys in an 8 hours day. If there are 42 workers in total, how many toys are produced every hour? In the question, student, he is saying that a factory worker, it means one factory worker, produce 28 toys, okay, in 8 hours. Matlab a factory worker in 8 hours he is producing 28 toys, okay, and we have to find in 1 hour to number of toys of the worker quantity is 42. Okay, 42 workers, how many toys they produce in 1 hour? Okay, 42 workers. First, we will make the data same as. Okay, I am writing here a worker. Okay, a factory worker, your worker, same as. a worker can produce in 8 hours, how many toys he can produce? 28 toys. Okay. And what we have to find? 42 worker can produce in 1 hour. Number of toys we have to find. Okay, now let's start the solution. Start now. First, we will find the a worker can produce in 1 hour. 1 hour, okay? Okay, how many toys he is producing in 1 hour? 8 are given. 8 are given. We will find the in 1 hour. Okay? Now write same as like this. In 1 hour, okay? So 28. Student, now same as we are going toward the biggest number to smaller number. So what we will do? We will divide. We will divide this 8 by 28. Okay. Now cancel this. 2 times 4 is 8 and 7 times 4 is 28. Okay, I cancelled this value by table of 4. 2 times 4 is 8 and 7 times 4 is 28. Okay, so answer is 7 upon 2 toys, okay? He is producing in 1 hour. Now we have to find the 42 workers. Okay, 42 workers. How many toys they are producing in 1 hour? So 42, I will write here 42 workers can produce in hour. Okay. This is the demand of question. Now student, now we have to find 42 worker can produce in 1 hour. What we will do? Student, we are going to smallest value to bigger value. 42 is the bigger. So what we will do? We will multiply. We will multiply. Now cancel this by a table of 2. 1 times 2 is 2. 2 times 2 is 4 or 1 times 2 is 2. Okay. Now I will multiply here 21 into 7. Into 7. 1 times 7 is 7 and 2 times 7 is 14. Okay, now I am writing the answer in proper description. Okay, that 42 workers can produce in 1 hour. How many toys they can produce? 147 toys. Okay, student, note this. This is your answer. Okay. Now, student, open your countdown book 6 and book page number 97. Exercise is 7A. Student, we have done question 1 on the board in lecture. Question 2.
Question 2 is your homework. Okay? I am reading the question. If a dozen eggs cost 36 rupees, find the cost of 7 eggs. In this question, student, 1 dozen, do you know the 1 dozen is equal to 12? First, what you will do? First, you will find the cost of 1 dozen. 1 dozen, it means 12. So, you will find the cost of 1 egg. 1 egg, so you will divide 36 to 12. After this, you have to find the 7 egg price, your cost. So, definitely, you will multiply this by 7. Same method as question 1. Okay, you will solve this question by lecture. Question 3, we have done on the board in lecture. Yes, we have done. This is the CW. Now, question 4. Question 4 is your homework also. The fastest man in the world can run 100 meter in 9 seconds. Okay? How far can he run in 1 minute and 2 seconds? Student, what we will do, look at carefully. In the question, he is saying, ki faster man can run in 9 seconds. In 9 seconds, he can run 100 minute. Okay? So, student, first you will find ki how can he run in 1 second. So, you will divide 100 by 9. And after this, you will multiply in 1 minute how many second? Definitely 30 second. You will convert this 30. Okay, 1 minute is equal to 60 second. Okay. So, you will multiply after this 60 and 2 second. The answer will be came. Now, question 5. If Afshin can read 39 pages of a book in half an hour, how long will it take her to finish a book that is 1287 pages? It means ki Afshin in half hour means 30 minutes. In 30 minutes, Afshin can read 39 pages. Student, first you will find in 1 minute. How can she can read in 1 minute? So you will divide 30 by 39. And then after this, how long? Definitely 1287. You will multiply the answer by 1287. Answer will be came. Student, 4 and 5 is your homework. And we have done 1 and 3.
Now, student, note your homework. Your homework is exercise 7A. You will solve these all questions in your math copy. Question 2, question 4, and question 5 is your homework. You can solve this question by lecture. Okay, student, now I will take your follow-up in our Zoom class, and rest of the question, inshallah, we will solve in Zoom class. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.